गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन. चैप्टर फोर एयर. लेट्स रिकैप्चुलेट चैप्टर. सो एयर दैट आर अर्थ इज सराउंडेड बाय ह्यूज ब्लैंकेट ऑफ एयर कॉल्ड एटमोसफेयर एंड इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर अर्थ बिकॉज आर डिपेंड ऑन द एटमोसफेयर फॉर देयर सर्वाइवल. नाउ नेक्स्ट कंपोजिशन ऑफ एयर. एयर इज अ mixture of actually it is a mixture of many gases like nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, helium, argon and other dust particles. Now nitrogen and oxygen gases which in great proportion in atmosphere, like you as you can see through pie chart, nitrogen present in the atmosphere 78%, oxygen 21%, carbon dioxide 0.03%, and argon and other argon 0.93%, and other all other like dust particles 0.04%. Now next is the structure of atmosphere. As you can see the structure of atmosphere. So our atmosphere is divided into five layers starting from the earth surface. So first layer is troposphere. This layer is the most important layer atmosphere and its average height is 13 kilometer. The air we breathe exists here like means oxygen, nitrogen, almost all weather phenomena like cloud formation, rainfall, hailstorm occur in this layer. The next, which is above the troposphere, that is stratosphere, and it extends up to 50 kilometers, and it is free from all weather phenomena. It making favorable condition for an ideal condition for flying aeroplane. And it is also known as the protective layer because it protects us from ultraviolet sun rays. Next is the middle layer, which is above the stratosphere, that is mesosphere. This is the third layer of the atmosphere. It is lies above the stratosphere. It extends up to a height 80 kilometers. All meteors burn up in this layer when it's come from space and enter in this layer. Now next one is the thermosphere, which is the layer which is lies above the mesosphere. All radio transmission occurs there because due to ionosphere which is have a electrical charge particle which helps in radio transmission. The next one is a exosphere, which is a very thinnest layer of the thin layer, and the light gases like helium and hydrogen float in the space from here. Now let's talk about the weather and climate. Weather, any one of you can tell me what do you understand by the mean of weather? What is weather? Weather is changing day to day and hour to hour, and it may be defined as a condition of atmosphere at the given place for a short period of time. As you can see in the newspaper, the everyday the forecast, because it shows the weather forecast, because it changed day to day and hour to hour. The next is, what is the difference between weather and climate? The climate is the average weather condition of a place for a long period of time, and it represents as climate of that place. That is why we have a daily weather forecast. After that, the meteorologists compile all these weather forecasts, and that they make the climate of that area. As the basic element of the weather, why the weather change day to day and time to time? Only because of the temperature, humidity, rainfall, sunshine. Same way, the basic element of both weather and climate, like temperature, humidity, rainfall, pressure, wind, sunshine, cloudiness. But the difference in between their duration and their degrees. And the information about this basic element continuously collected by the different scientists throughout the world, and these scientists known as meteorologists, and how they are collecting these things. So for collecting these things, they are use various kinds of instruments like the balloon, satellites, to get the information about the different weather elements, about sunshine, cloudiness, or rainfall. Fine. For example, if you visit your outside the cloudy sky with the possibility of shower or thunder storm in some area, so the weather of that area is very pleasant or humid. Fine. Now let's talk about. So today's your activity is that you collect yesterday, today, and tomorrow weather forecast and make out that table in your notebook. Tomorrow I will collect from you. You will share your that 3 days weather forecast in the class. Is it okay with everyone? So temperature is a degree of hotness and coldness. As you can see here, we use this kind of temperature to measure the fever human body. And here is you can see the Celsius is written because there are the two type of thermometer, centigrade and Fahrenheit. But it is here is written Celsius because the scientists those invented this kind of centigrade thermometer known as Celsius. So that is why here is a sign Celsius and Fahrenheit is written. So the major the unit which is measured to degree the hotness and coldness in centigrade, 0 degrees freezing point, and boiling point is 100 degree. In Fahrenheit, the freezing point is 32 degree F and the boiling point is 212 Fahrenheit. The important factor influence the distribution of temperature is insolation. It is totally dependent on the sunshine or the heat of the sun falls on the surface. So it directly falls on equator part. So equator, the temperature, when we move from equator to pole, the temperature decrease, insolation decrease. Next is the standard unit measuring temperature is degree Celsius, and it is invented by Andrew Celsius. Everyone please underline on the Celsius case, water freeze 0 degree and 100 degree Celsius in Fahrenheit. As you can write down over here, the degree of Fahrenheit, the freezing point is 32 degree Fahrenheit and the boiling point is 212 degree Fahrenheit. The crowded high-rise building of the city trap the warm air, thus the raise the temperature of the city. Now, next one is the air pressure. Air, what is air pressure? Air pressure can define as the pressure exerted by the weight of the air on the earth surface, on the surface of the earth. That is known as air pressure. And air exerted pressure from all directions. As we go up the layer of atmosphere, the pressure falls rapidly. The air pressure is highest at the sea level and the decrease with the height. As we go up the layer of atmosphere, the temperature falls rapidly and it is a highest at the sea level. The horizontal distribution of pressure is influenced by temperature of air at the given place. The area where temperature is high, air get heated and rise. What it means? It means the warm air, always get move upward direction. It creates low pressure area, and the low pressure is associated with the cloudy sky and wet weather.
This is a water bottle. In it, a straw. As you can see, it is a water bottle. In the water bottle, there is low water than the straw. There is a low pressure inside the bottle. That's why the water is not flowing. Now, I have a balloon. I will blow it. Now, I will just twist it so that when I would bind the mouth of the balloon to the bottle, it would not be, the air would not be escape. Now, I will just tie this to the mouth of the balloon. Now, as you can see, I am going to open the twist and the water starts flowing. Ma'am, the balloon has empty because of the high pressure, the straw made the water flow.
Thank you.